So what I'm going to do is just sign into SAFIS and walk you through some of the issues that we've been having and hopefully clarify some questions. So I'm going to go ahead and click on SAFIS eTrips. And I wanted to mention that if you have trouble reading this, if the text is too small, you can, with PCs, you can hold down Control Plus and make the font larger, and if you have a Mac, you can hold down Command Plus and it should make the font larger and easier to see. So if you have multiple license types, you're going to see them both listed here when you log in. And if you just have one license, you won't see this page. It'll automatically take you to the Welcome to eTrips page. So I'm going to select the Crab license. And to know that I selected the Crab license, I can look at the top of the screen under Fisher information, and it should say my name, license number, and license type. So if you're ever doing reports and you forget, am I on my charter license or my finfish license, you can look up at the top of the screen and this should stay there the entire time you are in that license type. So a couple of things I wanted to mention. One of them is favorites. Everyone needs to set up favorites for each type of license. If you have a crabbing license and a charter license, you're going to have different types of gear and different areas fished and different species. So in favorites, a lot of users have set up their header information and their effort information, but a lot of people haven't set up any species information. And the way to do that is on the left-hand side of the screen, there is a species list and you click the plus button to the left of the species that you're interested in, and it should list all the different options for that species. Like blue crab, for instance, has a lot of different options and a lot of different ways to report them. So everything should be listed here, every option. And when you select one of these, it automatically gets added to the list here. And it also allows you to choose the disposition. So if you select here, you can say personal use or remove for sale and add as many species as you plan on reporting. If you go to the bottom of the page, you'll see that there's an opportunity to add a dealer. So if you're selling to one dealer on a regular basis, you can look them up in our dealer search menu and select them. And then every time you report, you will see that dealer listed. And if you don't see your dealer listed, you can always email me and I will add it to the system for you. And make sure that any changes that you make in your favorites, you go back to the top and say save. The changes don't automatically save. And you'll notice this favorites saved thank you at the top. So another thing I wanted to mention is if you are adding a trip report, there are a couple of questions when you're in this Create New Trip Report menu. If you'd like more details on how to add a trip report, there is a trip report tutorial listed in the tutorials website. So I'm just going to quickly add trip information so that I can get to the frequently asked questions. So in here, if you navigate to the vessel information list and you don't see your vessel listed, feel free to go ahead and email me your vessel registration number and your vessel name if you have one. And I will put it into the system for you and you should be able to go ahead and add it to your favorites, and that way you don't have to select your vessel every time. So what I was going to say is if you have, let's say, the option to report female, male number ones, and male number twos crabs, like these three options, but you only catch ones, you go to the reported quantity column and you put down 3 bushels. And you don't need to put anything in these other two fields because they automatically will drop out of the trip. But what you do need to do is select sales disposition. So on the same line that you put the number 3 for male number ones, select sales disposition and you can say they were retained or discarded or private dockside sale or sold to a dealer. Whatever you ended up doing with them, select that. And if you've entered information into all these fields, and you double check that it's correct, you can go to the bottom of the screen and say save and complete. And it should take you to this page, which is the certification page. So you say, yes, I approve that this is true and complete and correct. So on this confirmation page, you can either click this edit trip button, which takes you back to the same trip you just entered, and you can change any of the fields. You can click new e-trip, which just means that you can add more e-trips and takes you back to the same page, but with all the fields empty. You can click print confirmation, which basically just prints a summary of all of this information. Or if you're done, you can click finish. So we'll go ahead and say finish. And it takes us back to the main eTrips menu. So here we are in August, and you can see the three trips that we have for this license. Notice that this is a commercial license, it's not a charter license, and if this person only crabbed three times in August, with this system, there's no need for this waterman to add negative reports for the rest of the month. We just assume that they didn't go crabbing in those other days. But if you have a charter license, we need you to account for every day. So what I recommend charter fishermen do is go in and add a negative report for a week, and then that following Sunday or Monday, go back in and enter your trips that you went on, and they will override the negative reports. And another question I get frequently is people seem to think that this calendar links to the trip report information, when in fact it's just a calendar. You can just look back at the different months and see what you've been up to. But if you want to specifically look at a trip, you need to navigate to the middle of the page and click on one of these edit buttons, and it will let you edit each trip individually. And one last thing about trip reports is once you have entered your trips for the month, there is no send button or done for the month button or anything like that. If you've saved a trip and you see it here and you see it on the calendar, it is in our system and we also see it, so you should be compliant for reporting at that point. So now if I was all done adding crab trip reports and I wanted to add some charter reports, I would navigate to the right side of the page where it says home and click the home link. Takes you back to the same page you came to when you logged in, and click eTrips and then just select the license that you wanted to report under. And I wanted to just show you a charter trip report really quickly and clarify a couple of questions about the charter trip reports. So when adding a charter report, you'll notice at the bottom of the page it says count and reported quantity. So count is the number of fish, and reported quantity is the poundage. And a lot of chartermen don't actually weigh their fish, so we don't always have accurate weights. And so what I ask people to do is if you don't know a weight, the weight of your fish, go ahead and just put a zero in there, and that way the system will let you save it. But if you do have the weights, go ahead and put the poundage on the right under reported quantity. And the count is, again, the number of fish. And then you can just save it as usual. So those are the general questions that I've been having. And if you have any more questions or you need more clarification, feel free to email me or call me, and I will be happy to help you out. And thank you for your time, and good luck out there.